For thousands of years, humans have used the power of wind to sail across our planet and discover new lands that were seemingly out of reach. What if I told you that there's a 400-year-old idea that applies the concept of sails to space that can make the edge of our solar system accessible in under 10 years of travel time? In the hands of the Sith Lord Count Dooku, a version of this concept was used when he escaped from Geonosis without a trace. How could we use sunlight to assail our travel woes in real life? The sun is a source of plentiful, free energy, and ever since 1608, harnessing it was an idea that BFFs Johannes Kepler and Galileo Galilei shared. It had since inspired tabletop RPGs like Star Traders, short stories, TV shows, movies, and actual solar sail missions. One example of solar sails in movies is Count Dooku's Pamorka 116, or the Solar Sailor. It's somewhat of a misnomer since it's not being pushed by solar pressure, but absorbs energy similar to a solar cell to provide energy to the ship. For someone on the dark side, he sure knew how to leverage clean energy. Maybe he wasn't so dark after all. Okay, maybe he was! As Space Biggie once said, mo photons, momentum. Solar radiation allows us to harness the sun like sailboats use wind. Each photon that hits your sail is transferring momentum onto your sail, which accelerates your ship. Based on the way the sail is angled, you can change directions, decrease, or increase the spacecraft's velocity. In the vacuum of space, you don't have the pesky air that we have on Earth, adding to atmospheric drag and slowing us down. There are several designs of solar sails used in pop culture, like Count Dooku's ship, and other concepts designed by space agencies here on Earth. Each one providing an advantage depending on the maneuvers you need to do and how you plan on deploying the sail. The principle of sunlight pressure pushing things around in space has been harnessed and applied already in several satellite missions. For example, Mariner 10 ran out of gas in their attitude control system, but flight controllers used this principle to allow the sun to spin stabilize the spacecraft by orienting the reflective solar panels to generate the spin. Unlike traditional rockets or ion propulsion, solar sailing is a very unique form of propulsion that was once thought to be impossible and still proves to be difficult, even though it has been demonstrated in the past. Scientists at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center are researching ultra-lightweight materials to use as sails, which can advance the use of this method in the future. There are many factors that contribute to the forces that can propel a solar sail. The largest factor is electromagnetic radiation emitted by the sun. Other factors that generate a force are solar wind, which is 100 times less effective as electromagnetic radiation, albedo, which is the reflection and scattering of solar radiation off the Earth, and Earth's infrared emissions. Calculating the amount of flux, or density of pressure, that the electromagnetic radiation from the sun contributes per square meter at our distance from the sun, the linear momentum that this flux generates is... This is a million times less than the pressure exerted from a dollar bill sitting on the table. This flux is so small that it falls below the threshold pressure required for us to hear. And so just like that bug that's crawling behind you, it's too small to detect its presence with our fancy ear holes. Well, if our ears were out there in space listening for pressure exerted by electromagnetic waves, not hearing the sun would be the least of your concerns. It's not just about the pressure, but the total force exerted over the full area of the sail. The larger the sail, the larger the total force. The acceleration that you get from a solar sail can be calculated using this equation, where nu is the sail efficiency, considering that the optical properties of the sail is not perfect. Just like a funhouse mirror versus a regular mirror, you want it to be as close to perfect as possible to get the most efficient use out of it. P is the pressure generated from the solar radiation, and sigma is the mass per unit area of the sail and its components. Based on this equation, we can make all kinds of fun calculations. Let's say you want to know how big of a solar sail you would need to transport humans to space. A solar sail 2 microns thick has an approximate acceleration of around 1 mm/s². This is what you get when you solve the equation for the area. Assuming the mass of the spacecraft is divided equally between the payload, structure, and sail, the area needed is 387 m² per kg of payload mass. That means if your payload is a tiny 5 kg or 11-pound payload, you'd need a solar sail the size of 1,935 m², or a sail the size of 4.5 basketball courts combined. If you wanted to transport the Orion capsule, which can hold 2 to 6 humans and weighs about 10,000 kilograms, you'll need a solar sail about 4 million square meters, which is the size of 1.2 Central Parks. Well, if you were one of the crew members accelerating at 1 mm/s², how long would it take for you to get to the moon? Assuming a constant acceleration, the distance traveled is calculated by this formula. Assuming we're starting with no velocity and are relying on the constant 1 mm/s² acceleration generated from the radiation pressure only, then the distance traveled is half of the acceleration multiplied by the time squared. To see how much time it takes to travel the 384.4 million meters at that rate, it will take approximately 10 days. At the 10-day mark, the vehicle will be traveling over 877 meters per second, or around 2,000 miles per hour, which is ridiculously fast. Likely, if this was a real example of sending humans to the moon on a solar sail, they would have to start their deceleration upon approach, and so it will likely take a bit longer. Traditional rockets can get you to the moon in just under 3 days versus the estimated 10 or so days using the solar sail. However, if you want to travel even farther in our solar system or beyond, the perks of solar sails really begin to shine. As payloads continue to be pushed by the sun, it can reach speeds that are far beyond traditional rocket speeds. Similar to the age-old story about the tortoise and the hare, eventually the solar sail tortoise zips by. This can be a huge savings in both cost and mass. No matter what method you use, it still costs somewhere between $9,000 and $50,000 per pound of payload that you're launching into space. If you don't have to bring all of that rocket fuel, you're already saving a tremendous amount of money. It's been calculated that using solar sails to make routine deliveries to Mars can save tens of billions of dollars in mission costs. That's a lot of cash. The solar radiation pressure on the sail also decreases as you travel farther away from the sun, with this pressure decreasing by about half as you get to Mars distances, and 10 times less as you pass Jupiter. Even with that decay, the free rays still make a huge impact. Voyager 1 has been trucking along for 44 years and is currently 18.8 billion miles away from Earth. Scientists calculate that we could catch up to Voyager in less than a decade using the solar sail technology. Cool! Scientists are also looking at Sirius A as the best target for solar sail traveling outside of our solar system, since the large star can provide a way to start putting on the brakes for the approach. Using solar sails, you can get to Sirius A, 8.6 light years away, in just under 70 years. You can imagine adding lasers pointed at the sail, which provides a nice boost from us Earthlings. Is someone shining a light on me? Ah! Space is dark and full of terrors. The only factor limiting how fast you cruise the galactic seas is how well your material can last against the elements of space, the mass of your vehicle, and how far away you are from the sun or the star that you're using. Light Sail 2's solar sail is made out of mylar, which is a polyester film used often in spacefaring missions for reasons such as its dimensional stability and reflectivity. This mylar sail has ripstops sewn in, just like a parachute, so that if a micrometeoroid by chance punches a hole in the sail, you can still continue to function while preventing the hole from growing in size. This mylar sail is 4.5 microns thick, or 1/5,000th of an inch. It's also pretty light. The entire spacecraft, including the sail, comes in at 11 pounds. So tiny. With Light Sail 2's launch on the SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket currently set for late June, we'll be one step closer to realizing the dream of affordable, long-distance travel by harnessing the free and ever-present rays from the sun. It's been a long time coming, and this tech is ready to take us places, because space! Thanks for watching this episode of Because Space. Remember to give us a thumbs up, and if you want to learn more about the Light Sail and the Planetary Society, you can join the mission over at planetary.org.